Hi guys, welcome to this 17th tutorial in this series of programming PIC microcontroller with MPLAB XC8 compiler. In this tutorial, we're gonna learn how to connect an LCD display to another port of a PIC microcontroller. In tutorial 5, we learned how to interface an LCD display to a PIC microcontroller. The default connections of an LCD display is on port B. We have received many queries of people failed to connect the LCD display to other port because it's not always convenient to have your LCD display on port B. There might be some devices that you like to connect on port B, so it's very important to learn how you can connect your LCD display to any port beside port B. Let's go to our MPLAB XC8 code. When our project runs, we're gonna display LCD tutorial. After 2 second delay, we're gonna clear the screen and then we're gonna display LCD on port B. Because in this first example, we're gonna connect our LCD display on port B. Then we're gonna change the port to port C and we're gonna learn how we can modify it. As we have learned, to control an LCD display, you're gonna need 3 delays. Delay for 18 cycle, delay for 15 millisecond, and delay for 5 millisecond. These are our delays functions, and we just created a simple function to create a delay in a second. Instead of calling this delay millisecond and specify the delays, we're just gonna call delay second, and inside the bracket, we're gonna write our integer value, which is gonna represent our delay in second. LCD clear. Instead of calling this function all the times, we're just gonna write a function LCD clear. This is gonna make our code easy to understand and very neat. As we have learned in the 5th tutorial, before writing any command to the LCD, we must always use this function to check whether the LCD is not busy. And only when it's not busy, then we're gonna send this function or whatever function that we're gonna have to write. This is another function that we're gonna use in this tutorial, LCD move. Instead of writing this function, stddrmaddress, if you wanna specify the address of the cursor, we're just gonna call this function and we're gonna specify which row or which column to move our cursor to. Same story here, before writing any command to the LCD, it's always good to check whether the LCD is not busy. And this is our main function. Just after 1 second delay, just gonna call second delay and specify the number of delay. In this case, it's gonna be 1 second. As we have seen here, we're just gonna write the value of the delay in second. We're gonna call this delay second function. And this is how we're gonna configure our LCD. As we have learned it in the 5th tutorial, open xlcd 4-bit. We're gonna use our LCD in 4-bit mode. Only 4 data lines gonna be used. If we use 8-bit, then we're gonna use all these 8 data lines. In this case, we're just gonna use the 4 data lines. This is just to turn on the LCD display. And remember, before sending a command, we're just gonna check whether the LCD is not busy. And this is to move the cursor right. And this is to turn the display without a cursor, without a blinking cursor. Then after that, we're gonna display LCD display. Whenever our LCD is gonna switch on, we're gonna display LCD display. This is the function to write a string of characters to the LCD display, put rsxlcd. And after 2 second delay, we're gonna clear our screen. We're gonna use this function we created to clear the screen, this function. Then in an endless loop, a while one loop, we're just gonna say LCD on port B and then move the cursor to the beginning of the first row and first column and so on. This is our include file that we're gonna use. Before using the LCD function, you'll have to include this xlcd.h. This config.c, just our configuration bit files. We selected the frequency HS because we're gonna use 8 MHz oscillator. The power timer is disabled, watchdog timer disabled, the MCLR pin is enabled, And pretty much the rest of the stuff is just standard. Most of the stuff are disabled. Let's run our project and go to our simulation. Build successful. Let's run our simulation and see the LCD switch on. Then LCD tutorial. And after 2 second delays, it's gonna write LCD on port B. Let us change our connections and connect our LCD to port C. By the way, we use the PIC 26K20. This is one of the newest PIC microcontrollers. It's not always good to be stuck to the old PIC microcontrollers. The new PIC are cheaper, and there is no really reason to be stuck to be using the old PICs. Stop. Just gonna connect all my data lines. Gonna connect everything to port C. Mirror X. D4 is gonna be connected to RC0. D5 is gonna be connected to RC1. D6 to RC2. D7 to RC3. The enable bit is gonna be connected to RC4. The RS pin is gonna be connected to RC5. The RW pin is gonna be connected to RC6. If you're not gonna read anything to the LCD, then to save some extra pin of the PIC microcontroller, you can connect this RW pin to ground and everything is still gonna be fine. Save, and if I run my project, you're gonna see nothing is displayed to the LCD because I connected my LCD to port C, but my code is still referring to port B. So let's go to our library and change the default connection. Most of the people, they always ask this question. Why in the code they did not see anywhere where we declared the pins of our LCD connections. So there is no need really to specify at which port your LCD is connected to in the code because everything is specified in the LCD library. In this document, MPLAB C18C compiler libraries, if you go to the LCD section, I'm going to say Control F, LCD, external LCD functions. These are the functions that are used to control the LCD as we have learned it in the fifth tutorial. Busy xlcd to check if the LCD is still busy. Open LCD to configure your LCD. Put cxlcd to write a byte to the LCD controller. Put sxlcd to write a string, and so on. We have learned all these functions. What is going to interest us in this tutorial is the micro for selecting the LCD pin assignment. It said the precompiled versions of these functions use default pin assignment that can be changed by redefining the following micro assignment in the file xlcd.h found in the H subdirectory of the compiler installation. The default connection, the enable pin is connected to port RB4, the RS pin on RB5, the RW pin on RB6, and the data lines are connected to port B. So if you want to connect your LCD to a different port, then this is where you have to change this default connections. Then further down, it says, after these definitions have been made, the user must recompile the xlcd routines and then include the updated files in the project. This can be accomplished by adding the xlcd source files into the project or by recompiling the library files using the provided batch files. Okay, let's go to our xlcd library. If I hover my mouse over the xlcd, it says Control Alt click to open the included hierarchy. So I'm gonna press Control Alt and click. It can open the xlcd. Double click. This is our file. It says this library routine are written to support the Hitachi HD44780 LCD controller. This is the controller that we are using. And we're gonna change. In this line, it says data port defines the port to which the LCD data lines are connected. We're gonna connect our data line to port C. So I'm gonna change C. tri-state data lines, data port C, W pin. I'm gonna connect it bit 6. So this is gonna be port C, port C. I'm gonna do the same port C. The RS pin is gonna be connected to C5, and the enable pin is gonna be connected to C4. Change this as well. And that's all, guys. We're done with this library. If I go to my main file and compile my project, it says access denied. In most of the case, you're not gonna have access to edit any library in this folder. So what is important, you have to go to that folder and log in with administrative right and enable the right to modify the files. We said that file is located inside the installation folder of your compiler. I've installed my compiler in my C drive. Program files. Go to microchip. XC8. This is the version of my compiler. And in the include P library. This is our libraries that are supplied in this compiler. What is more interested is xlcd.h. Let me go back some few steps. Back. This is the folder. I'm just gonna modify the right of this folder so that I can be able to edit whatever is inside. Right click, properties, security. And as a user, I'm gonna select a user. I'm gonna edit. And I'm gonna give this user full control of everything. So I'm gonna change the permission. The user is gonna have full control. Apply. And if I come to my project and say save, you're gonna see now I'm able to save because I've got full access to that folder. And if I run my project, I'm just gonna use clean and build project because it's gonna build everything. Build successful. Let's run our simulation. Run. You can see nothing displays on LCD yet because there's still one step that we haven't done. In this document, it says, after this definition has been made, the user must recompile the xlcd routines. And to do this, this can be accomplished by adding the xlcd source files into the project or recompiling the library files using the provided batch files. In our case, we're just gonna include the xlcd source files into our project. If you go to the installation folder again, if you open source, PIC 18, P library, this is a xlcd. This is the xlcd source files they are talking about. We have to include these files into our project. To do that, we're gonna say in our source files, right click, add existing item, and then you have to go to that installation folder. We install our compiler in the C drive. Program files, microchip, XC8, sources, PIC 18, P library, and open xlcd. Then let us include all these files one by one. Gonna start with the busy xlcd. To be just on a safe side, we always prefer to copy this file into our local project. So whatever we edit is just gonna edit our local file and leave the rest of the files which are in the installation folder intact. So we're just gonna select the first file and tick this copy so that it's gonna copy a local copy into our project files. Select. Add existing, select the second one. We're gonna do this for all the files. add existing. This is the last file. Write data, select, and we have added all our source files. Let us rebuild the project again. We're gonna use this rebuild everything clean and build project. Building. Build successful. Let's go to our simulation and run. You can see this time our LCD works, LCD display on port B. Let us change that message and say LCD display on port C. Build again. Build successful. Run the simulation and says LCD tutorial. LCD on port C. As you can see, guys, it's not difficult. What is important, you just have to know on which port you want to connect your LCD and go to the xlcd.h file, edit the connection files to the desired port, include your source files, rebuild your project, and voila! Thank you guys for watching this tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe to this YouTube channel to receive more tutorials. And I'll see you guys in next tutorial. Thank you.